I thank the organizers for giving this opportunity to talk. Today I'll be presenting data from the Tata Memorial Hospital in Mumbai with intraepithelial chemo over the last 4 or 5 years. Retinoblastoma, we all know, is an aggressive childhood malignancy in the eye, and it's grouped A to C, E with increasing disease load. The standard of care up till now was 6 cycles approximately of chemo followed by focal therapy, but we know that it achieves excellent result in the lower group eyes, but in the higher group eyes it shows less favorable outcomes in many of the advanced eyes requiring either enucleation or EBRT. So the destiny for advanced retinoblastoma is often enucleation. Intraepithelial chemotherapy is, we all know, a new regimen relatively performed in over 31 countries worldwide. In Tata Memorial Hospital we do it as a one day admission procedure under GA, where the common femoral artery is accessed and the ostium of the ophthalmic artery is accessed, and the drug is injected in a pulsatile fashion over 30 minutes. The choice of drugs could be either melphalan, topotecan or carboplatin, or a combination of the three. At the conclusion of procedure, the catheter is removed and pressure is applied. The children are discharged the following day. This is a brief video.
Can we continue? We all know this.
Okay. The potential advantages, we all know, it is a higher concentration of the drug within the eye, and the complications can be local or systemic. Now, the experience at Tata Memorial Hospital, we excluded children who were less than 3 months or weighing less than 3 kilos, and we excluded the lower group eyes, the group AI, and also the eyes with unfavorable group E presentation like diphthalmos, glaucoma, anterior chamber seeding, thysical eyes, and those with extraocular disease. We treated a total number of 33 subjects and 42 eyes. And the total number of sessions were 133, and of that, the 138 were total attempted sessions. That comes to a mean of 3.16 sessions per eye. We had a technical success rate of 97%, that would be the mean follow-up of 12 months. We do not have a RETCAM at present at the Tata Memorial Hospital, hence I'll be presenting the pictures along with the ultrasound pictures. This is a 4-month-old child with a group B retinoblastoma who had a good response in two cycles of chemo. Another case was a 6-year-old child with unilateral retinoblastoma, again a group B. He also had 2 sessions of intraarterial chemo. In this particular case, we had a good response, but there was a vascular incident here. So this was the tumor size, and the tumor regressed well. So the complications which we encountered were lid edema, chemosis, ophthalmic artery spasm, and a few cases with mild suppression. So this is one case of retinopathy which we saw. In this case, the tumor, this is an inferonasal tumor which regressed very well, but the vision in that eye wasn't great because of this was a vascular insult.
So why this case was not treated, say, with intravenous chemotherapy? Just a question.
That tumor was very large in size. It was the height of the tumor was it was not accessible for local therapy. Yeah. So this is one of the fallacies of pitfalls of intraepithelial chemo.
So you have case selection, I think, is number one pitfall.
Yeah.
Really is. I mean, we all want to do new things and wonderful things, and that's great. But just cases,
I wanted to highlight this aspect of. Out of the 42 eyes, 8 eyes were B and C, the rest were D and E.
So that's
34 eyes.
So B and great. But that's the way I think we should see the data in
so
the future.
We prefer to treat group D and sometimes group E eyes.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Do you have any questions?